I'm Emily, and today we're going to go over the science of acid-base reactions. For this experiment, you're going to need some baking soda, some lemon juice, or you could use vinegar. And if you want to make it colorful, like I did, you need a little bit of food coloring. So first I'm going to show you how to make your baking soda colorful if you want to. First, you just need a little bit of water, and just throw in a couple of drops of food coloring there. And swirl that around a bit. I'm using blue. And then I have a cup of baking soda right here. You just need to add a few drops of that, maybe a tablespoon or so. And then go ahead and stir that around just like that. Now, for most acid-base reactions, the final product that you're going to get is water and a type of salt. So for our acid-base reaction, we have, see, very colorful. Now for our acid-base reaction, we have baking soda. The chemical name for baking soda is sodium bicarbonate. We have lemon juice, which is mostly made up of citric acid. And then on the other end of our equation, we're going to have H2O, water, our salt, which is sodium citrate. And then what makes it really fun is carbon dioxide. So we're gonna get some carbon dioxide bubbles, which is going to make this beautiful rainbow bubble display right in our pan right here. Now let's talk about the pH levels of our ingredients. Lemon juice has a pH of around 2 to 3, between 2 and 3. A baking soda solution has a pH of 9. Now what does this mean, right? Well, the pH scale is our scale of how to determine how acidic or basic something is. And it goes from 1 to 14. But the really important part is to remember that the pH scale is on something known as a base 10 logarithmic scale. So a pH jump from 1 to 2 is actually a tenfold jump in difference. It's a really big difference. Something that has a pH of 1 is 10 times more acidic than something with a pH of 2, which is 10 times more acidic than something with a pH of 3. So that means something with a pH level of 1 is 100 times more acidic than something with a pH level of 3. So it actually makes a really big difference. So now that we understand that, let's do our science experiment. So we have our baking soda all lined up nicely in this pan. We have our acid just waiting to be added. Let's see if I can get a really good view of this. Oh, makes me a little bit sad to mess up this beautiful display. But here we go. Here's our acid. Whoa, and that is an acid-base reaction. Look how beautiful that is.